And new developments tonight in the Jesse Crow murder case. The Prunedale man accused of killing his wife, Ryan, was back in court today. And for the first time, we're getting a sense of the magnitude and scope of this murder investigation. With a look at the amount of resources and manpower that have been poured into this investigation, we go to Action News reporter Felix Cortez, who's live in our Salinas newsroom.
Well, Aaron, it's huge. In fact, it's so complex that today Crow's defense attorney asked for more time so he can review boxes of evidence.
The Jesse Crow murder case is not a simple case, according to his defense attorney, Jim Eager, who asked the court to hold off on setting a preliminary hearing for his client so he could go through all the discovery. And there's a lot of it.
Large number of police agencies within and without California, large number of civilians that have been spoken to, a large number of recorded material, so we haven't even had a chance to go through it.
Prosecutor Stephanie Holsey objected to the extra time. A further delay in the preliminary hearing, she said, only punishes the family of Ryan Bunnell Crow.
Not to set a preliminary hearing because we've given so much discovery is, in effect, keeping the victims in the case from getting their right to a speedy trial and speedy proceeding.
In court Friday, we got our first glimpse of the magnitude of this murder case and the resources used to investigate it. More than 1,200 pages of discovery have been handed over to the defense, including 45 DVDs, videos, and audio cassettes of interviews. More than 145 investigators, detectives, and police have worked on the case from a dozen agencies, most of them from outside Monterey County, even outside the state.
I can't confirm where the investigation has occurred, but there has been an extensive investigation, as indicated by the amount of pages of discovery that we've been turning over to the defense.
Prosecutors have said they have a mountain of evidence and DNA samples linking Jesse Crow to the murder of his wife. What they don't have is a body.
I'll tell you frankly, I've never had a case where they don't have a body and they don't have witnesses that I'm aware of, or instruments, whether it's weapon or something, that I'm aware of. And so there's a lot of unknown pieces here.
Well, today the judge denied the defense the extra time to review all the discovery that his office has been handed, and he set Crow's preliminary hearing for July 1st. Prosecutor Stephanie Holsey said not until after that hearing will District Attorney Dean Flippo decide on whether or not to turn this case into a capital punishment case. Aaron.
All right, Felix, thank you. Jesse Crow's girlfriend, meantime, Summer Donovan, who at one time was considered a person of interest in Ryan Bunnell's murder, has some legal troubles of her own. Donovan, who's seen here helping Crow clean out his Prunedale home, was arrested early last year for drunk driving, which she eventually pled guilty to, and was ordered to install an interlock device on her car. Donovan will be back in court next Friday asking a judge for permission to remove that device. Prosecutors in the Crow case aren't saying if Donovan is still a person of interest, but they have said they don't plan to charge anyone else with Ryan's murder.